One, today we're going to talk about an interesting one that I find myself, again, like all these videos, I find myself talking about this a lot, so I decided to make a video about it. Something that really nobody's talking about, at least as far as I've heard, and a lot of actors and artists, entrepreneurs and stuff seem to be unaware of this, or especially people coming out of 9-to-5 work, moving into either a gig or, you know, like production, moving into sort of a gig industry and maybe company ownership. So like with all videos here, I'm going to start with just sort of some overview stuff and then maybe give it some more practical tips. But really this one is about a mindset element that's called opportunity loss and respecting your time. And I find that a lot of people get confused with value that I speak to about DRASIS, our community, you know, where we help actors and media artists create business and creative autonomy and independence by building either production companies, ad agencies, or you know, creative endeavors, side hustles and stuff to start financing their acting in a relevant way that pushes their acting career forward. So if you want to find out more about that, there's a link in the comments below or in the description below. But we talk about that there a lot, and in conversations that I have with prospects for our program, when people submit applications and we sort of talk to them to see if it's a good fit, I find myself explaining this concept a lot. And also in DreamReach Media, our production side of things, I find that people who are not business trained or haven't reached a certain level in their lives or careers, not just age-wise, but also just independence-wise and success-wise, they tend to not think in these terms. So when you talk about value, I don't know what I'm going to write, but I'm going to start writing. That's why I grabbed these, because things are about to hit the whiteboard. Talk about value. Green's a good color for value, right? Value is in the eye of the beholder, right? So value comes from a problem or a desire that somebody has, right? And there's a potential solution. Solution to this problem or desire, right? And the solution leads to a desirable situation or outcome. And the more severe this problem is, and the better the solution, the more likely this person is to get to the desired situation, is really how value is perceived, right? So value is really the perception of fulfilling, you know, getting somebody from their problem or desire state to the desirable outcome. And then how badly this person wants to get here determines the value of what it is that they do. So if somebody, you know, this can be, you know, problem desire can be somebody wanting to stand out and be like a hotshot and be recognized and feel good about themselves and feel successful. So they might invest in designer clothing and a maybe, let's say, a car. Like, you really want to show off your success. Even if, you know, you're not that successful, you can go out and you can, you know, get a Lamborghini on payment plans, and that is value. You want that image so badly that you're willing to sacrifice something else in your life to get to the desired situation and go out and get a Lambo. So you live in an apartment as long as you can afford your Lamborghini and look good, right? Or the problem could be something more serious, like what we deal with, where actors are frustrated with their 9-to-5 and they're frustrated with being stuck in their current state and nobody giving them opportunities that they know they could fulfill and do great at. So they want to figure out how to take matters into their own hands by starting their own businesses, which enables them to be more light on their feet, make more money, start productions, you know, cast themselves, grow into the industry. They want to know how to do that. So that's a big problem, a big desire. And the solution is Dresis, and the desired outcome is creative and financial independence, right? So that's value too. So value is everywhere. That's, you know, the more rare something is, the harder to achieve it, to purchase it is, the higher the value usually is. So that's why like a Van Gogh or a Picasso can cost hundreds of thousands and hundreds of millions of dollars actually to purchase, because there's a finite amount of them and they're famous artists, and people who like to collect will pay a lot of money. So that drives the value up. So I hope that makes sense in terms of the way people perceive value. And I need you to understand this concept first so that we can get into the second concept, where we start actually talking about respecting your time and your opportunity loss and what that really means. So when we talk about time, here's where a lot of people go wrong, right? Time is essentially pure value. There's no way you can argue that. If you value your life, you understand that time is the most important thing. Your time, your personal time. Every second of your life is pure value. Why? It's finite. You'll never get it back, and it is running out. The minute you're born, it starts running out. It is a depleting battery. Here's where you start, where you're born, and then at some point, you're in the ground. All of us deal with this. What you do with this time is completely up to you to a certain degree. I want to be fair to people in unfavorable circumstances that have to divide their time into, you know, various responsibilities. That may be out of their control. You might have a family member that, God forbid, fell ill. You might have people, children, family, bills, you know, like everybody has responsibilities, right? But everybody also has moments in between that they're not dealing with those responsibilities. And it's really what you do with this time that can change your life, right? So you understand that respecting your time is probably the most important thing that you need to start doing as an actor. So when you start wasting time, first and foremost, you have your responsibilities, right? Those take up, you know, let's say you have a gauge here that's divided into three equal parts. One part should be devoted to your work and responsibilities. One part for rest and refreshment. And one part for charity and education. Your usual vocations should fit like sort of in this work and this space, and you know, you should give yourself enough rest. So people don't have as many hours in a day as they think, in their life as they think. So what you do, you know, here where you have your work responsibilities, so let's say that's 8 hours. These are three parts in a 24-hour day, which is, you know, really you have three 8-hour sections here. And you know, this doesn't have to be equal, actually. So like the charity and education can take 2 hours. Well, that leaves 6 hours. What are you going to do with the rest of those 6 hours? Well, you should do things that move the needle. So the rest of your time needs to be dedicated to the 20% of activities that cause 80% of your success. or your movement forward, okay? You shouldn't be spending your time on anything else. So, what does that mean? Respect your time, what does that mean? In order of priority, things you can do immediately. Cut social media time and limit it to an hour a week. No, I'm not kidding. Two, remove time wasters from your life. I mean people. The friend you talk to 2 hours a day? Stop it. If you have goals, if you have dreams, stop it. You don't talk to people regularly to just shoot the crap. It's procrastination. You're finding things to do to fill your time. You should fill your time with the 20% of activities that'll move the needle forward. If you're not working on your craft and you're not working on your business and you're not taking care of responsibilities, that means you're procrastinating. And if you want a social life, look, everything needs a bit of a sacrifice, right? But limit it to Friday nights. Period. And don't blow all your money, because also that needs to go into the right things. Which brings us to the second part, opportunity loss. So when it comes to time, what I hear people saying time and time again, no pun intended, is, let's say, I'll use the conversations I have on the phone with people and Dracis and our reps, you know, talk to people all the time. Is it a cheap program? No. Okay, what do you expect? It's a life-changing thing. So we get to the point where we discuss the price, for instance, the value, going back to what we started with here. And people kind of see the value, but then all of a sudden these, you know, their current mindset starts coming in like, oh, well, I can't afford it right now. All right, well, what does that mean? You can't afford it right now, or you won't prioritize it right now? So like you don't have the access to any of the money, or you do, but you just want to wait and think. And then that, like, the anxiety kicks in, right? And then there's like, okay, well, our first reaction is, you know, fight or flight. But really our first reaction is like, okay, well, let me think about this. I want to wait, okay? So, let me break this down now. You have a problem, okay? You have this problem. That's why you saw the solution. And you reached out to talk to us. I'm using us as an example. I'm not saying this is your, but this is what I'm saying. We're on a call with somebody, right? We've discussed this problem. They've said more over and over again that, oh, it sucks, and I have a 9-to-5, and it's a waste of time, and I don't know how to get started, and oh, this sounds great, and all that. So we offer the solution. We say, hey, so what's it sound? How's it sound? Oh, that's perfect. That's amazing. And then, you know, they believe that we're the company to do it for them. And then the price comes up, and because it's not $3, suddenly it's like, oh, well, wait a minute, I make $20 an hour, so really, yeah, I don't know. So waiting, let me think about it, let me wait. Well, if time is the most precious thing in the world, aren't you losing by waiting? And I don't mean this just in the context of my business. That thing you wanted to do, that trip you wanted to take, that person you wanted to talk to, that move you wanted to make, those kids you wanted to have, that dog you wanted to buy, that thing you wanted to go to, that film you wanted to make, that community you wanted to join. Aren't you losing by waiting? Because what? Something magical is going to happen, and then suddenly the price for whatever it is that you're after is going to disappear. It ends up costing people so much to wait, even a year, because if you have a solution to something, and let's say, like with Dracis, let's say it's educational, right? Let's say it's mentorship, right? You have mentorship. What's the most important thing? Time, right? What does mentorship do? It saves you time, right? And if it saves you time, it saves you money. Why? Because you can do what you're trying to do. If it takes you 3 years, if it takes you 5 years without mentorship, and the mentorship can accelerate your success by 4 years, and it takes you 1 year to do what you wanted to do and now can do, because let's say, and we're going to go away from my program, but what, let's say you find a program that costs $15,000, right? And you make $40,000 a year. Okay? And the program shows you a way to get to building a business that makes you, not even anything crazy, $10,000 a month. Okay? Let's stray away from the $40,000 because my math isn't good. Let's say you make $3,000 a month. Okay? And this says if you pay us $15,000, you're going to make $10,000 a month. Or let's say it's about booking roles. It'll help you book roles. You know, again, Dracis contributes to that too, but it's not all it's about. But let's say you can get one guest star role, one co-star role or something out of a training, and it accelerates you in that direction. Now we start getting into the second the topic here, opportunity loss. I don't even know what to use to point at stuff anymore. Opportunity loss. Because we're talking about time, value over time, investment in saving time, investment in doing things right, and also just, you know, the sheer expense of making mistakes is tremendous. But let's just talk about the time, because that's what this video is about. If you make $3,000 a month, and somebody can show you how to make $10,000 a month with your own business, and you make $3,000 a month at a day job, at a 40-hour-a-week job, you are paying to make $3,000 a month, you're essentially paying $7,000 a month and losing uh, 40 hours a week. You're paying the difference between what you could be making for the time it'll take you to figure this out yourself. Does that make sense? So you're paying $7,000 a month for as long as it'll take you to get to $10,000 a month on your own. But all you can look at is the $15,000 that it's going to cost you now, right? But $15,000 and you losing $7,000 a month is slightly, little over 2 months of operating at $10,000 a month to recoup your investment. So if it took you 5 years or 4 years to get to $10,000 a month with your own business, which, by the way, if you start your own business on your own, it probably will take that long. And if you don't invest in things that'll train you, you know, even longer, whether it's acting or it's production or whatever, then really, what the opportunity loss of not paying these 15 grand ends up being is, let's say it takes you four more years. I'm gonna need a calculator. Calculator. 4 years is, I think, 48 months, right? So 48 months, you know, $336,000. $336,000 in opportunity loss by not paying $15,000 to learn what you could learn in 5 years in 1 year. Respect your time. Make the right choices. Invest where it matters, dismiss what doesn't. Focus, invest where it matters, dismiss what doesn't matter. Put your time on the things that count and grow this knowledge. And sometimes that means, well, Daniel, you know, I don't make the kind of money to even get started. I'm sorry, I don't buy that. Because you can trade your time temporarily to do something that you don't want to do to build a cushion to get the thing that'll help you. If I didn't have $15,000, and I've spent over probably $100,000 at this point in just random trainings. That doesn't even count for the experiments that I've done on my own with wasting money and whatnot to figure out if something works or not. If I didn't have 15K right now, and I worked at a day job for 40 hours a week that paid me $3,000 a month, I would look at my bills and I would figure out how much I could put in a piggy bank, if anything at all. And then I would take those 15 grand and I would break it down into I would think about all the things that I can do. Drive Uber, drive Lyft, sell tomato juices from the back of my car, help people with their lawns, shoot a wedding video for somebody, whatever. I would think of all the things I could do. And I'd say, okay, if I get Uber, Lyft, or rideshare service, or whatever, you know, if I do Postmates, if I do anything like that, if I this, if I that, if I mow 15 lawns, let's say you can make an extra $100 a day. An extra 50 bucks, all right? An extra 50 bucks a day, and you work 6 days a week, right? That's another 300 bucks a week that you can now start putting away, okay? It's gonna take you time, but again, if you take, let's see what that would cost. So if you save $300 a week, and that by working double, it's crazy, you're working 80 hours, then you have $1,200 at the end of that month in the bank, which means in 10 months you have an extra $12,000, which means another $3,000 that you know you could probably save from your day job, or if you want to work a couple more months, then you could probably save those 15K. And then you could invest that in a year, right? Save, work hard, so 2x your efforts, focus those 20%, that extra time that you have, not on social media, on making more money with whatever, rideshare, and work relentlessly at 2x your work capacity, 80-hour weeks, for 1 year. Okay? And invest the 15K into that dream program. And most programs are less, ours included, FYI. Quite a bit less. You're still 1 year longer than what it would have taken you if you could just afford it right away. But you're still 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 10 years faster than learning it yourself. And once you do this, then it might take another 6 months to a year to find success with this, because it will take a lot of work for you to do it. But if you're committed, you will do it, and then you'll start making money with this, and then you'll make $3,000 a month, and then $5,000 a month, and then $10,000 a month, and then suddenly you're making six figures, and you're in the industry that you want, you're producing, you're acting, you're making films, you're running a business, whatever it is, and you've done it still in many years less time. And you had to hustle for a year. This is the problem. People are short-sighted. They don't have the long-term ability to say, you know what I... They just want immediate results. Like, nobody's going to help you build a six-figure business like tomorrow. And if you're not going to invest in it, what are you on that you think somebody would help you do that with the amount of resources and effort and knowledge it takes to do that, to think that somebody would just give that to you for over a weekend and you would suddenly be doing this? This is a lifestyle shift, right? But if you really want the things that you want, then you have to go for them, and you have to respect your time while you're doing it, putting the focus on the things that move the needle specifically, and remembering that opportunity loss, losing this time by not taking action, is costing you a lot of money. And that $300,000 figure, I mean, that's just one way to calculate it. Think of the roles you're not booking. Think of the friends you're not making, the relationships you're not forming. Think of all those things that end up circling back in the long play that help people out in this industry, in the entertainment industry. Think of every day that you're working some 9 to 5 as a tenfold waste of time of what you feel like it actually is, because you're wasting a third of your day fulfilling some other person's dreams, and it's taking away the best hours in your day, and making you go home with half the energy left, too lazy, too tired to do anything that really matters anyways. And if you are that hustler that still manages to do the stuff after work, it's not as good as it could be if you weren't at that job, right? So every day I would get upset. It's not easy to do what I did and build it up. Like, I'm not saying me. I'm just saying it's not easy to be entrepreneurial. But to me, it's better than depending on people. So I'll take the risks that you have to take, and the frustration sometimes, and the failures and all that. That you, as long as you can build the building blocks that'll carry you through those things, and you have a supportive community. Hint, hint, races. Click the link below. Then you'll be okay. You'll always get back up. But if you get fired from your job, like, what are you going to do? People thought they were safe. And then in 2007 or 8 or whenever everything crashed, people lost all their money because they were employed and they had stocks. People with their own businesses pulled out of that. Not everyone, but, you know, a lot of them did. Anyway, that's it. I hope that helps for actors. I hear this too often, and I'm actually glad that I just kind of randomly thought about that today, because it's a topic that I wouldn't have probably thought of just to make a video about, but it's one of the most important things in your lives. So respect your time, and don't forget about opportunity loss. What you don't do today, even if it's a week later, you could have been working in that week. You could have been working and getting closer to your goal in that week. Don't waste time. All right, see you next time.